a new Fox News poll finding former President Trump still leading the pack in the GOP presidential primary. 56% of primary voters preferring Trump compared to 22% in favor of Florida Governor Ron DeSantis. And in the never vote list, former Vice President Mike Pence is at the top. 35% of those same Republican voters say they'd never vote for the vice president, while only 13% say they would never vote for Trump. This is the never vote poll. Joining me now is former special assistant to President Trump and America First Policy Institute Chief Communications Director Mark Lauder. Also joining me is former New York State Senator and Democratic strategist David Carlucci. Good morning, gentlemen, to both of you. Mark, I want to start with you. These poll numbers have been really fascinating because President Trump, after not one but two full-blown indictments, first in New York and then the federal indictment, gains ground in the polls. How do you explain that?
Well, I think each time you see these indictments come down, the American people are seeing that the government is being weaponized against them, and Donald Trump is just the person that they are targeting their ire after. But it continues, whether it's calling parents domestic terrorists, and you can go down the line of how we have a two-tiered justice system. So they see this. It's a narrative that has been building for many, many years, and that's why Donald Trump continues to get stronger each time they go after him.
But David, he faces 37 federal charges over the classified documents. These are serious charges. There's also now more of an escalation with regards to Georgia. Maybe those that are, you know, responding to these polls aren't really kept up on the fact that there is more coming against the former president. Still, he continues to build and build. What's going on, in your opinion?
Yeah, I think we can all learn something from President Donald Trump as political strategists. He's been masterful at rebuilding the Republican Party, at gaining support, and really digging in that support from the right. However, and that's what the poll shows, but I think the problem will ultimately be that it's gaining Republican support, but ultimately it will lose the general election. Look, Donald Trump, he won in 2016, but has been on a losing streak since then, whether it's himself or candidates that he supported. So it's one thing to see, hey, how do you win a primary? Hey, Donald Trump has been masterful. However, how do you win the general? I think that's still open for debate, but I believe he's going to lose in 2024.
If indeed it's President Trump, you say he loses to, we assume it's going to be President Biden, but we can't assume anything because A, it's too soon, and B, a lot can happen between now and then with the current president's health and obviously these indictments. So to be continued, I guess, is the best way to phrase this. Let's talk about this.
Right. These polls show that whether it's Biden or Trump, they are the strongest that we've seen in 20 years of a primary candidate being so far out ahead. So my money's on Trump and Biden and in the general.
Yeah, and then you've got a lot of polling that says that nobody wants to see Trump or Biden. They want new blood and new faces. So I do want to move on, though. Centrist group No Labels says that voters increasingly want an alternative option if the 2024 race comes down to Trump and Biden, but some say that could be a benefit to President Trump. Mark, how do you respond to that? Because there has been questions about President Biden's health and his wellness in particular over the last few months.
Well, it doesn't really matter who the main party nominees are going to be. I mean, there's two factors here when it comes to third parties. Number one, you know, will they siphon away votes in a general election, and who are they taking those votes from? Are they taking it from the Republican or the Democrat? Generally speaking, if you're going to take them from both sides, it's going to leave us right where we are. The bigger question is could an actual third party candidate get to winning a state or two and keeping either party from getting to the 270 it takes to win? If that's the case, then the Republican will become the president because of the way the Electoral College breaks down if neither candidate gets that magic 270 to win. So I think right now, if there's a third party, it benefits President Trump, both in terms of who they would take it away from, the votes from in a general election, or if they were to actually pull off the unlikely and win a state, that just helps the president as well, too.
Well, you know, David, let's go back, and you can look to the Ross Perot time in the nation's history, mm-hmm. and here are all of the candidates. And again, you know, I think the question mark here, in particular on the GOP side, I realize you're a Democrat, but on the GOP side, that, you know, a lot of this can split you know, the vote between those that are that don't support President Trump, President Trump ends up gaining in the primary. But David, you know, on the other side of this, you do have challenges to President Biden. And I think that the polling has been very surprising, in particular when it comes to Robert Kennedy Jr., who has gained ground. And remember, President Biden, his name is not going to be on a couple of states, which caused a lot of controversy. Why would you not want your main candidate's name on a state? Why have that box unchecked for President Biden? But I guess that's their strategy.
Well, if we look back at the poll we talked about earlier, it shows that Donald Trump is doing well with his party, but who's doing even better with their party is President Biden. Even with RFK and some other candidates popping their head up, Biden is in really good shape. And if we talk about the No Labels organization, to me, it looks like a real fallacy that it's built on this premise, like Mark said, that has so many things that have to be lined up. They have to increase voter turnout. They have to win over partisan votes. They have to get on the ballots. They have to get 37% nationwide if they're going to move forward with their plan. Allegedly, that's what they're saying. So I think at the end of the day, the no limits thing is just off the table. It's not going to happen. They're probably planning for a future election down the road. And this all bodes well for President Biden. Of course, there's a lot of talk about who this potential candidate could be if it's a third party, but that's a big mystery. And once you put someone on the ballot, it's not just an idea, it's a person with all those pros and cons. And in this political climate, it's mostly cons. They've been talking about maybe Manchin or Hogan. These are people that aren't polling well with attracting new voters that haven't voted before to come out and vote. So I think that whole premise is really just an idea.
Please join the conversation. Put your comments and suggestions below in the comment section. Thank you for subscribing to this news channel. You will be notified of any breaking news and new post as you become part and parcel of the MACAD TV family. Please like and share MACAD TV. We love you all. Please support MACAD TV Foundation by joining membership and visiting Amazon UK to purchase the displayed books to aid our orphanage projects across Africa.